Hey makers, this is Thruveen and in this episode we are going to discuss about how we can customize custom command bar in model driven app. Now in model driven command bar we can easily write different PowerFX function. Also we can upload our own custom JavaScript function and open our custom pages in different dialogues. During this episode we will be first talk about how we can customize the command bar in model driven app. Then we will write some PowerFX command on top of that. After that, in the first episode we have created one custom page, so that custom page we will integrate with different dialogues into model driven app, and we will pass the context from model driven to canvas app. So without further delay, let's get started. Also, one more important announcement. If you haven't followed me on Instagram so far, please do follow me. The Instagram ID is this one, and the link is available in the description box. So without wasting much time, let's get started and talk about customize command bar using PowerFX and custom JavaScript function in model-driven app. Here I am on my machine and here I have opened one IT help desk solution. We have developed one IT ticketing system in my earlier episode where we have created one model driven app for admin purpose. We have created one canvas app for end user and we have created one canvas page for grid. And we have already implemented a functionality that how we can pass the context from our canvas page to model driven app. If you haven't visited my earlier video, the link is available in the description box. Now in this episode I am going to talk about how we can customize command action bar in model driven app. So let's say for an example, this is one model driven app that we already built. Now we are going to customize all of this action. We will add our own custom command bar action over here. Also, we will talk about how we can write the PowerFX formula on command bar and how we can write JavaScript code to open our canvas page into different dialog. Now, let me show you the end outcome that we are going to achieve throughout this session. So first of all, here I created one button called PowerWrite. When we click on that, basically it will open this type of notification for us because I have written some notify code on top of that. Now let's say I wanted to open my canvas page into side panel. So I created one JavaScript function and call that from my command bar, and basically it will open the responsive canvas page over here as a side panel. Same way, let's say for an example, into this video I have performed one more thing. I have created one more canvas page with the help of PCF component, and basically this is useful for analytics purpose, and I want to open this report as well into side panel. Then I have created one more button over here, that is open report, and this is opening this beautiful dashboard for me into this left navigation. So these are the PCF component developed by Low Code Era. I will provide you more information about this later on this video. Also, these are the component which are available as plug and play mechanism. You just need to install the Low Code Era packages and you just need to directly use that into your canvas page. And this will generate the beautiful dashboard for you. Definitely, I will provide more insight and information about the Low Code Era custom component later on this session, as well as the link for Low Code Era is also available in the description box. After that, we are going to open the same canvas grid into center dialog like this, and we will open that as a full page. So let's say I'm clicking here, and basically it will open and load this canvas page into full page. After that, let's say I'm selecting any record from here, and let's say I want to pass my model driven context to my canvas app. Then I can pass that using the command action and code that we are going to write into jQuery. So whenever I click on open record over here, basically it will pass that context in form of query string parameter, and according to that appropriate grid will be opening here into canvas page that we have created. We are going to cover all of these things in detail throughout this session. So lots of learning, and if you wanted to skip the specific part, then the chapters are available as a part of description box. So use the chapter and redirect to the specific point that you wanted to go with. Now let's get started with the development part. First of all, I have opened my model driven app that we have created in the earlier session. Now we want to customize our command bar. First of all, open the pages section from here and click on the area section that you have created and click on edit command bar. This will prompt you that which command bar you want to edit: main grid, main form, subgrid and associated view. Now what do we mean by all of this? This information is provided over here as well as in form of graphic. In our case, we want to customize our main grid command bar. So let's edit that. It will open this type of modern editor for command bar. To add the new command, just place the cursor where you wanted to place the new command bar action. So I just wanted to place that over here. So I will click on here, new command, and that will add one button after this refresh button. Just provide the label. I'm providing here as PowerFX. Now we need to provide the icon if you want. So let me just provide one icon from here. So I'm providing this type of icon. Tooltip if you wanted to provide. Tooltip description if you want to provide. Then you need to provide here that you want to write a formula or you want to use the JavaScript. So basically here I am going to use the PowerFX. So I'm going to use run formula and click on open formula bar. So that will open the formula bar for you. Here just type a command notify, and inside notify let's provide hello, and the type is success, right? So this is how you can create your PowerFX code on here. Also, you can create the similar type of buttons. Like let's say for an example, you wanted to provide the approve and reject functionality for your ticket, then you can create those type of buttons. Then over here on select, basically you can pass the context from the selected row, and basically you can write the patch code into PowerFX to update your record. So this is the another use cases that you can do. If you wish that I can prepare the separate video on that, please write in the comment section so I can get to know that you are looking for that video as well. Now this is how the basic PowerFX. Now let's say for an example, let's just save and publish. Make sure that you save and publish your changes frequently over here, otherwise if you refresh the window you will lose your changes. Now let's talk about second thing. In the demo I have shown you that I want to open some of the custom pages as a side panel, center dialog and full screen, and also I want to pass the context from model driven to canvas. How can I do that using JavaScript? So this is one official documentation from Microsoft. I provide the link in the description box as well. So it has provided the different JavaScript function. Basically we need to simply copy and paste this code, replace the page name and necessary information, and then we are good to go for creating those things. I'm going to explain you how to do it in very easy manner. So this is the code which is opening the full page without context. This is the thing which is opening the full page with the record context. This is something which is opening the center dialog, and this is something which is opening a side dialog, right? So these are the different code. Now let's get started and talk about this thing in detail. Let me just open up my command editor again And now let's add one more new button. Provide the name of your button. So let's say provide that side dialog. Right? And now if you want to provide any icon, you can provide. I don't want to provide that. And after that, you need to provide an action. So you can use JavaScript file or you can run the formula. So let's use run JavaScript file. Now over here, basically you need to provide the JavaScript function. Now for that, let me show you the trick. So first of all, what you need to do here is you need to create one JavaScript file if you wanted to open your page into side dialog. So let me just open up my Visual Studio Code over here. You can use any editor which you have. Now let me move towards the documentation, and first of all, let's open the page as a side dialog. I'm copying this code, go to the Visual Studio Code, pasting this code, and this is looking like this. Now this is something which is opening the page into side dialog, and basically it is passing the different variable, that page input, navigation option, and this is calling this XRM.js. Now here you need to replace that with the page name and dialog title that you want to provide. But before that, this is not a JavaScript function, this is a normal code. So basically you need to provide the name of your function. So just provide function side dialog, right? Curly braces started, and at the end curly braces ended, right? So this is how we have added our code as a function. Now I already created one JS where I pasted the exact same code, right? So what I need to do here is I just created a function load custom page as side pen, and here in the page input, basically I just provided the logical name of my custom page that I want to open. That's all. And I completed that function. So this is the function. Now how to find the logical name of your page? So let me show you. For that, you need to go to your solution. In the solution, you just need to check here what are the page type over here. So over here, this is the IT grid 1 page that I want to integrate. And what is the name for this one? So this is the name for this page. So you simply need to copy this name and paste it into your code. So this is the thing that you need to do. And title is something which you can provide any name. I want to provide side page IT help desk. So I'm just providing that. That's all, right? So this is how my custom page as side pen has been created, right? Now it's time to load this JavaScript file and test this functionality. So now once your JavaScript file is ready, basically you need to add that as a web resource. To add the web resource, there are two ways. First of all, let me show you the easiest way. Go to the web resource, click on new, click on more, and click on web resources. So this is opening this type of modern dialog. Just upload the file. So this is the file that I want to upload, custom dialog function. So I'm opening that. Now you can provide the display name. I'm providing the display name as YT custom dialog. You can provide here as well any name, YT custom dialog. This is JavaScript file, and you can simply save. And your resource file is being uploaded. So this is the first way. Another way is that you can directly click on add library over here, and from here you can simply click on new. So once you click on new, it will open up one ASCII editor where you can upload the file, but I will not recommend that way. So let's go here and let's search for the file that we just loaded. So let's search for YT. And this is the JavaScript file that we just uploaded. Click on add. And now what we need to do here is we need to provide the name of the function. So let me open up Visual Studio Code, and this is the name of the function, to open up the custom page as side dialog. Let's paste that name and we are good. There is one more option to pass the add parameter. So if you wanted to pass any parameter with this function, you can pass by clicking on add parameter. Let's not focus on that right now, but I will show you one more example with the parameter. And after that, you wanted to show visibility where you wanted to show this particular button. So always show, which is fine. And now let's save and publish the changes. Now, similar way, let me do one more process for another button where I want to open this analytics as well into side panel. So first of all, let me just give you an overview that how I have created this canvas page. Like in my earlier sessions, we have created the canvas page. The processor is exact same. Only thing is that this is one analytics page where I want to configure the different graph, that how many tickets are created by different category, how many tickets are created per department, per priority, and what is the number of ticket by each individual status. So what I have done here is I have used a custom PCF component over here. This PCF component are ready made available, and I have downloaded that from the low code ERAS private preview program. So first of all, let me just show you what type of component provided by that low code ERA, and let me just quickly show you how you can simply add that. So this is the official website of lowcodeera.com, which is providing different PCF component. If you wanted to check which type of low code ERA component it is providing, just click on this lookbook section. Over here, you will be able to see the different component, like it is providing different type of UI component, like text boxes, progress bar, some good type of date picker component which you wanted to have, some data grid, powerful data grid, then buttons, icons, some powerful type of card visualization, vertical nav bar, horizontal navigation bar. So many type of ready-made components are provided by LowCodeera. So basically, these are the component which are provided as a solution package. For my demo, I have using this type of chart component. So many different type of charts they are provided here. So you can just visit this lookbook and check out the different features. I just installed the solution provided by LowCodeera, and after that, I just added all of code components from using get more component option. And once you upload the package provided by LowCodeera, all the plug and play components are available for us to use. So you can directly use that into your page. So at this moment, I have used a couple of charts over here. And basically, the configuration process is also very easy. It is providing a very good user interface to set up the different UI option for your graph. And basically, you just need to provide specific type of collection over here. And they have a very good guideline into their documentation. So if you just open the docs.lowcodeera.com, basically they have shown the step-by-step process for adding the component. So let's say in my example, I have used bar chart. So I just opened their documentation, and over here they have provided the different static collection or dynamic collection example, depending upon the data structure that you need to provide this type of structure to your data. And once we form this type of structure to our data, so this will generate the beautiful graph for us. So I just use that concept, and on the on visible of this site, basically I created the code for all of this particular thing. So this is something I built this canvas page, and now I publish that and add it to my model driven page. And now I'm going to open that as a site name. If you wanted to check more about this custom component, the links are available in the description box. So visit the lowcodeera.com website and you will get all the information from there. Now let's coming over to the main point, where we are going to add one more command action over here, and where we wanted to open the LowCodeera analytics that we have created. So now let me just duplicate this button. So I'm just clicking here and clicking duplicate. Let me just change over here, open report, and now I'm going to use the same code. So I'm going Visual Studio code. I'm going to copy the same function and pasting over here, and just changing the name of the function as LowCodeera components. And over here I need to change the page ID. So same way, I will go to my solution here this is the custom which I created, and let's copy and paste this name to our code. So I copy and pasted the same name, and here I changed the title as IT analytics. And now I'm going to copy this function name and going to provide into the command action. So let's go here, and I'm going to load that with the same JavaScript file. So basically now you are making the changes, right? So for that, what you need to do is basically we have selected, this is the YT custom dialog.js that we have uploaded. You can simply click on this edit option. So basically this will open up this kind of user interface for you. From here you can choose your own file again, and you can add the additional functions over here, but I already added that, so I'm not going to make change. But if you add the additional function, just paste those and save and publish those changes, right? Now I'm directly going to use this function over here. So I'm just providing the name of the function as low code era components, right? And over here the function name was load custom pages side pane, right? Rest of the information is same. We are going to use the same JavaScript file across all the command actions, right? So we are good. Now let's do some more code over here. Now I've just wanted to open my canvas library as a center dialog. Then how can I do that? I need to go here again, and I need to copy and paste the same code, and I need to go to the here and need to create one more function, right? Now don't worry, I'm going to provide this final script file into my GitHub repository. You can download it from there. So over here I have created one more function, load custom page as center dialog, and now I need to provide change the name of my page. So I wanted to have the same page like this, so I'm just copying and pasting that ID. Same way, this will open it as a full page. So I'm pasting this again, saving the JavaScript file. Now let me just duplicate my buttons. Let me just duplicate this one, duplicate, change the name, center dialog, and this is the full page dialog. Now just change the, now our JavaScript file is the exact same one. Let me just open up that again, and let me just re-upload my file. I'm uploading my file again because I have added more functions. So I just uploaded that and published this file. Now if I open the text editor again, you can see all of these functions are appear to me over here, meaning the JavaScript loaded properly. Now we need to go here and change the name of the functions over here. So file is the exact same library file, but over here let's change the name of the function. So let me go here and let me copy the name load custom page as center dialog. So I'm copying this and pasting over here as a center dialog, and same way I'm copying this load custom pages as a full page and provide it over here. Right, so we changed the name of the function. Now let's paste everything together. So for that, let's click on save and publish. Once you publish this thing, you need to publish your model driven app again. So this is the model driven app, and make sure that all the custom pages that you wanted to use, you already added into your model driven page, like this IT grid one page and custom chart page. Both the pages I already added. Now time to publish this thing again, because once you edit your command bar, you need to publish your model driven app again. And once we are done with all of this thing, it's time to publish all the customization from the solution. So let's open up the solution, and now click on publish all the customization. If you don't follow this step, you will not reflect the reflection. So make sure about this thing. all the customization has been published successfully. Now it's time to for testing. So let me just open up my model driven app and play that. And here we are. It has loaded the entire command bar over here for me. Now let's test the thing. PowerFX thing we already tested. It is showing us the notification, right? Then side dialog. So this will open the canvas page as a side panel. And when you are opening that for the first time, it will take some time. So be patient. Let's say I wanted to open up the report that we have created with the low-code Eras component. I'm clicking on open report. And this has loaded this beautiful dashboard for me, where I can check the entire analytics as an admin, that you know how many tickets per category has been created, how many tickets are per each department, and how many tickets by priority, and how many tickets are in pending or in progress or completed. So entire status report I can see with this particular PCF component developed by low-code Era. So this is how this beautiful dashboard is loaded as a side panel into model driven app, right? So just try this low-code Era component and build this type of dashboard. Now let's test this. Now let's click on this center dialog and open up the canvas page as a center dialog like this. And you can see that this is totally responsive canvas app which I built into my earlier session. So it has opened the things accordingly. And same way, if I wanted to open that as a full page, you simply need to click here and it will redirecting you over here into full page. And you can see it is opening this grid for us. Now let's say for an example, my requirement is something like, let's say when I'm selecting any record, and at the time one ribbon option should be appear for me on top, and whenever I'm clicking that, it should filter my data set and open up the grid for me. So how can I achieve that? Let's see. The concept is something where we are passing the model driven context to our canvas app, and that is the very important use case. So let's see how. And basically you need to copy the some line of code over here, and don't worry, I'm going to provide the code as well. So let me just open up my JavaScript file, and now let me add some more function over here. I'm going to create a function called OpenRecord. So OpenRecord is something which is taking the input parameter from your grid. So basically I just pass the string parameter over here, and that is passing the record ID for your table, right? Now over here you need to provide the name of the page, entity name of your page, and where you wanted to open that, you need to provide the target. So here I provide the target as 1, which is exit similar as, it will load that as a full page. If you wanted to open that as a side page, you can provide the different target option over here, right? Now let me just change the page name which we have already taken over here. So let's pass that. And same way over here in entity name, basically you need to provide the logical name of your table, and the logical name of the table is, let's copy and paste, opening the solution here. This is the logical name of the table, crb45_tickets. So let's do that. So I pasted that crb45_tickets, right? Now let's re-upload the file and add one more button. So I am going here again and taking one more new command, and I'm providing the name as open record. And now let's provide some icon. Now let me just click here, run JavaScript, and we wanted to use YT file. And we need to provide the name of the function, open record. And meantime, let me just re-upload the file. So I'm clicking on edit, and let me just upload the file again. Uploading the file again. Save and publish the changes. Now we need to provide the parameter as well, which is basically passing the context from model driven to canvas. And just click on this add parameter, And over here from the options, just select the first selected item ID. So let's select that. And now let's just have a condition that it is show on the specific condition from the formula. And now let's just click on save and publish. Now we need to make some changes into canvas page that we have created, because this command action is basically passing the context from here as a query string parameter. And in canvas page on start, basically we need to grab that parameter and write some line of code over there, and depending upon that we need to display the grid records. So for that, let's edit our canvas page. So this is the canvas page IT grid 1. Let me edit that. So this is my canvas page which I built. Now let me click on app and let me just open on start event. Now here we need to write some line of code. The code is like this. We are setting up one variable. So let me show that code to you. So we are setting the record item variable. If the parameter record ID is blank, then we need to pass that as a blank, means we need to show all the record. Else we need to show the record with the specific record ID that is passed from here. And this is some manipulation on GUID I have performed over here. So basically GUID function I need to use, and from parameter I need to grab this record ID, and I just wanted to perform some substitute operations over here, right? So don't worry, this code is also available in the GitHub repository. And once we are setting up that record item variable, we need to change the item condition into gallery. So basically here we need to provide a condition like, if the parameter is blank, show all the records, else the record item that we just built. So let me just remove this code and let me just provide this line of code. If the record item is blank, then load the entire table, else load the record item, right? So that's it. Publish this code. So make sure one thing, that whenever you are making any changes to your canvas page, and if you have added that canvas page into model driven app, then you need to republish the model driven app again, otherwise the change will not be reflected. Let me publish this version, and now let me move towards the model driven to publish the app again. So this is the model driven. Let me publish this app again, and now I will publish all my customization from solution. Publishing all the customization. Now let's play the model driven app. Now let me select any record from here, like install Windows 7. And over here I am able to see open record. Let's click on that. So it is passing the context in the query string record ID in the form of GUID. And now it redirected me to the canvas page which I built. And you can see the record is filtered, and I'm only able to see the record which I have selected from my model driven app. So this is how you can simply pass the context from your model driven to canvas app. With this, I covered almost everything. Let me precap everything. So basically we have started our development process by adding different command actions in the command bar. So we have added the action for PowerFX. We are opening our canvas page into side dialogs. Then we have used the low code era's custom component and opened them as a side nav. Then we have opened the canvas page as a center dialog and full page dialog. And at last, when we select anything from here, we open that specific record for the selected item. So that's all about customizing the command bar and command action with modern app designer. Hope you love this content. And what next do you need for this canvas app model driven integration? Please share your thought in the comment section. Hope this video helps you and values your time. If it is, please hit thumbs up and share this video with your friends. If you are for the first time to my channel, make sure you hit subscribe to never miss any updates from me. I created a separate channel called Digital Dhruvin for Hindi content and short content. Do subscribe this channel. Looking for any consultancy? Here is the website. If you are looking to follow me on other social media handle, this is the URL. Please do follow me on Twitter and Instagram. And if you are interested for audio podcast, this is the podcast channel. With this, This is Dhruvin signing off. See you in the next session with some amazing content. Till then, have a great day. Goodbye.